there was a documentary shot and screened at home in the UK on BBC. It was called The 64-Day Hero, and it was about the story of Randolph Turpin, the boxer, and his rise from nothing in the Midlands in the UK to becoming a champion of the world. And his story was, the first part of his story was incredibly inspiring for someone like myself, who's come from these kind of working class backgrounds and aspires to making something better of yourself. And Randolph Turpin did become the champion of the world. He got a fight with Sugar Ray Robinson and beat him in London at Wembley, and became the champion of the world. He was a real outsider, and he put Sugar Ray down and became the champion of the world. And he was the champion of the world for 64 days. That's why it was called the 64-Day Hero, because there was a clause in the contract that he had to fight. If he lost the fight, he'd have to fight Sugar Ray again, and so he could reclaim his title in a return title fight. So Randolph Turpin went to New York to fight at Madison Square Garden with Sugar Ray Robinson, and it was there that he lost the fight and became the fallen hero, really. And his was a story from there on down. It was a real tragedy. He ended up taking his own life, and real tragic circumstances. And what really attracted me and my friends to the story was that we had a very slight connection to the Turpin family. We used to go, and you can ask Davey and Richard after half time or later on this night if you bump into them. We used to go every night. We used to go to this club in Rhyl called the Bistro on the seafront, and it was there that we heard all the music that changed our lives and forged our dreams and our ambitions over a pint of lager in the bar. And on our way in, we'd meet this girl at behind the counter where you paid the money, and her name was Siobhan, and she was the daughter of Randolph Turpin, the boxer. She was a very quiet girl, quite enigmatic. And when we all put two and two together when we saw this documentary, and I thought, well, I should write a song because it's got a real connection to where we come from. I think I should write a song about Randolph Turpin and see where it goes. So I started putting these lyrics together, and I started coming up with a song. And I wanted to get the facts right because of our connection to the family. And so it was only a very thin thread of a connection, but it was there nonetheless. So I started to check out the facts with the family themselves. And anyway, I was working on the song late one night, another songs, and there was a knock on the door in my village where I live. This must have been about 2 a.m, which is kind of strange. So I opened the door, and there's two very shadowy figures at the door with trilby hats on. And they said, "Are you Mr. Peters?" I said, "I am." I didn't feel like saying I am, but... the hair was so big, I couldn't deny it. And I said, "Yeah, I'm Mike Peters. Yeah, what's the score?" And he goes, "We hear you writing a song about Randolph Turpin, the boxer, the champ." And I said, "Yeah, that's right. And how do you know?" And they said, "Well, never mind how we know, but for the sake of your future health, we don't ever want to hear that song getting published or heard in public. You got it?" I've got it. Shut the door, never saw them again. Song never saw the light of day. Now that was 30 years ago. So I kind of figure I'm safe. What have I got to lose? So I came across the drafts of it in my lyric books, and I thought it'd be nice to play. It helps with the picture of either Hurricane helps paint possibly a clearer picture. Anyway, this is a song called The Ballad of Randolph Turpin. His father died coughing in the bloody song. In a young black child, his name lived on. In a black country jealousy factory gym, he was born a box, born a win. This is the ballad of the 64-day hero. The ballad of a man who would be king. The 64-day hero. He was a great
only British hope on a post-war generation. From the back streets it came, Black Panther by name. In a fight for the world, they said the tiger would fall. To the Robinson King who said goodbye to them all. To the 64 day hero. To the 64 day hero. Sugar Ray rolls in a big Cadillac. Grabbed off a boy, he rides on track. He bullied that man for 50 straight. His way to fame. This is the ballad of the 64-day hero. The ballad of the man who would be king. The 64-day contender of the world. On the 90-day clause, reserved by in New York. I did my best, but my best was not enough. The 64-day hero took it some. He was the 64-day hero, that's all. The 64-day
Randolph Turpin.